Who asked the question?
The Dorings fans. We don't have yet, but
she will. We do?
We definitely
do. We definitely do.
It's your first video. Nobody's even seen you yet.
Hey, if you disagree with us, that's awesome. We want to hear your thoughts. We want to hear your questions, your concerns, whatever it may be. We need to be a culture that's open to conversation and healthy communication. So there are a lot of different confusing issues today.
Like what?
Oh, thank you for asking. I'm glad you did.
Same-sex attraction.
So look, we understand love. We understand tolerance. We get all of that. We get that there's a place for all of that, but we need to look at things.
We gotta look at things.
We gotta put on the glasses.
The binoculars. Put them upside down even if you want.
We gotta start looking at things from the lens of truth.
Upside down. Like he was saying, we get it. If anyone there who is struggling with this attraction, or has friends struggling with this, or family members, whatever it may be, we want you to know we get it. All of us, every human being, all humanity, even this guy, I'm not sure if he's including humanity or not.
I don't know. Identify as a human.
You know, walking on the line a little bit.
So question number one, if you have a desire to do something, does that make it right to actually do it?
If I have a desire to hit John Paul with a pillow.
Exactly.
Does that mean might I have, be right,
does that mean
on
I should
what
do
I'm
it?
Doing.
I don't know, depends.
If I have a desire to
murder someone.
To murder someone, that doesn't make it right.
Just because you have these feelings, these desires, that is not a sin in itself. It's when we act on those desires or we entertain those desires, that's when it becomes a sin.
Yeah. And I mean, take it all the way back to the Garden of Eden. Like, Adam and Eve weren't kicked out of the garden until after they had sinned, not during the temptation of Satan tempting. Humongo point number three, your identity. If you are experiencing homosexual attractions, if I am experiencing heterosexual attractions, whatever, I am a son of God. Like, you are a son of God, you are a daughter of God, you are a child of God.
Don't identify with your inclinations or your desires, because you're more than that. So when the church is teaching something, the church is doing it so that we can actually live a life of abundance. For example, an analogy that I've heard used is that there's a playground on this hill, and it's this like tall cliff, right? And so around this cliff are walls to protect these kids. Now, the kids might complain thinking that, oh, well, there's these walls there, like we're restricted in our freedom, we're not able to go and explore and blah, 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 blah. But the teachers, the people who are in charge of this, know that the wall actually gives them more freedom, because then they can run around and play as much as they want without the danger of falling off the cliff.
So one of the greatest film producers ever
was named Joseph Schlegel.
Yes, him.
This guy right here.
Name was Cecil B. DeMille.
That guy too.
Yes. He produced this movie called Ten Commandments. He said, you really can't break yourself. You really can't break the Ten Commandments. You can only break yourself against them.
Boom.
Boom.
Kefa dropped.
You're always going to, after breaking a commandment, experience some type of hurt, some type of guilt, some type of shame even.
And God didn't come to bring us into condemnation or shame. With him there's freedom, with him there's love, with him there is life.
So St. Augustine, one of like the greatest saints ever.
Like right under me, like right
exactly,
there.
Exactly. Before he attained sainthood, he was a sinner, okay? He
big
was
sinner.
Huge.
Like,
huge.
So
sinning.
Bigly. Like, lust was a game to him. Like, he loved it, loved the pursuit.
That whole lifestyle.
That whole thing was his thing.
Just roll into a ball and eat
exactly.
it up, and that was
that's how lust works. So this guy, big sinner, came to a conversion with Christ because he recognized that his heart was restless until he rested in the Lord. And so once he knew that, he strove after that, like with his entire heart, with his entire being. And so I want to invite you right now, whatever brokenness you've experienced, whatever ways in which you've just been hurt, whatever ways in which you've just been let down, whether it be by yourself or by others, just invite you to let the Lord in, because your heart is going to be restless until you rest in him. You aren't going to experience that abundant life that only Christ can give until you allow him to give it to you.
So if you have questions, comments, feel free to post them, feel free to ask, feel free to make your own video on a comfy couch, hitting each other with pillows and all that jazz. Yeah, so bring it. We love you guys. You're awesome. Keep on pursuing God. Keep on journeying towards truth and love together with the cool
exactly.
right there.
And God made you special.
And he loves you very much.